Copy and paste jobby. Let's get this finished off. I can't remember if I did both sides already, so... Oh no, wait, this one isn't the dual manifold. Yeah. I showed you how knackered I was last night. So this is the one where I'm going to add three more machines to the end. Which means I need to rip out that back wall. The alternative I could be doing here is just copying and pasting the entire machine. And then I'd have to go back and pick up all of the wire. Because I understand why it does it. But I'm of the opinion that if you are pasting an identical recipe over a machine, it should not eject the contents. Generally, the idea is that if you're pasting a recipe into a machine, it's possibly a different recipe, so you need to evacuate the contents rather than destroying them. But still really rather tedious. So is that actually already... Oh, yeah. Disoriented, I was forgetting what direction this was travelling in. We're already making the wire at the right rate, it's just the cable was in. Let's add four tiles on. I mean, it might be more, it might be less that's needed. doing that shit just yet, so we can free that up. I do remember that I need to top up that stack. Should be good. Yep. Just gonna start a quick wire while we're there. No, wait, I do need to be in here. Yep, we're good. Looks like a good estimation. offload some of this wire. Let's go do the 16th machine on the reinforced iron plate. Just while I'm still in the mindset for doing buildings rather than signage. sorted, I think. Thank you. times by 27.5, 83.23 recurring. Is it just the one input of sheet? Yep. 55.4889. So what's the top number of circuit boards? It's Mark 2. I got TAA on again. Thank you. I'm not still playing Satisfactory. I have slept myself. So there is that. Still doing the same thing though, rebalancing machines. On the, I'm actually like building out the circuit board. Of course, I got the plastic-free circuit board all. So once I get the raw quartz in, I'll actually be able to get these being made. 397 times 27.5. Which numbers? Oh, right. Well, let's go back to the signage. So, this manifold needs to make 58.73125 unit a minute of circuit board for high speed connector. Okay. And we have the silicon circuit board recipe, which we've selected because it's plastic free and electrode circuit board is banned. I forget why. It's on the, there's a sign on the door says why. So we take 58.73125 divided by 12.5. I'll just wait for autosave to finish so that calculator responds. So we get 4.6985, so that means we need 5 machines to produce all of the recipes that we need, all of the parts that we need for that recipe. So we divide that number by the recipe amount, times by 100, and we get the clock speed of the assembler. So we got that in there. And then we need to make silica as well. So we times that by 27.5. So that gets us the accurate. Yeah. So that gets us the accurate amount of silica we need, because you can see that says 25.842, but the calculator says 24.84175. You can see this in a couple other places, like one of the recipes is clocked to 2.8125 a minute, but some areas of the UI say 2.813. So we've got this figure. So we go over to the constructor for that, and this does 37.5 a minute. So we need to divide that number by 37.5, times it by 100, and we get a decimal string that is probably a recursive number, but we can only enter 4 digits into the percentage field and have, like, you know, a reasonable certainty that that number is exactly what we entered. So we round up the last the fourth digit, which gets us 9114, and that's what we put in there. So then the next thing to do is take that number and multiply it by the number of machines. So we've got, let's just say 16 times 5 is 80. So the silicon line needs to be a Mark II belt. Okay, well, the supply line here. No, not the supply line, the production line needs to be Mark 1. So the silicon, the quartz line for silica needs to be Mark 2. And we pop over to one of the assemblers. See, that's 25.842, so we just say 26. And that is more than a Mark 2, so that means it needs to be Mark 3. Then the only thing left to do is complete the belting and plug them in. Barring any rebalance for high speed connector, this floor is now done. That's why it's entirely walled in. with the exception of one of the floors I was working on earlier in the week, whenever a whenever a production floor, whenever a production floor gets like completely done with its manifold and like, oh, I don't need to build any more machines, that's when I completely encase it. Like, one of the ingot floors, before I put all of the machines in, I just put one machine per thing so I can get the spacing correct. So like, I'll do the spacing, do the clocking, I just only build one machine, then quickly built it in. I'll leave the back walls up, but I'll like put bits of the sidewall in. See, nuclear power. I've only unlocked nuclear power twice, and I've never actually set up nuclear power. I've always ended up restarting before I ended up deploying it. Well, about the same here. Let's make sure that's set to overflow. There we go. So, ignoring the bit where we haven't plugged them in. So we have all of the circuit boards we need for the entire maps production. And like all recipes we could possibly be building, because we, you know, pre-planned it all. And we have overflow lines in, so anything that overflows from high-speed connector or computer production overflows straight to the warehouse. Although I'm not sure what I'll be using circuit board for, because I don't use trains anymore. What are they used in? Okay, so you need circuit boards for crafting a jetpack, priority power switch and radar tower. So yeah, I will still be like doing circuit board from warehouse. But like, once I finish building radar towers, that'll be it. Let's get this remaining stuff wired in. I forget if I mentioned what my goal was for this, is to just do one machine's worth of stuff per recipe plus whatever parts I need for everything else. Actually, I think I might have mentioned it the other night. I have a vague recollection of waffling on about the time I ended up building a 3 kilometer train station and thinking, like, no, that's far too bloody long. Because it was like 3 kilometers starting around about here and it would have ended around about here or something. Might not be 3 kilometers, might be 300 meters. Or whatever like length it was going to end up poking out through multiple biomes. Missing building. Not being able to really process excess heavy yellow residue. Cool. 96525. Oh, 525. Get this noted down. 942083. Them off. Eight 8 4 1 6 6. Divided by 10 times 100. 1291. probably starting to remove a bunch of those. But we already had them placed, so. Eh. Oh, this is redistributing, not producing. Right, 9, 4, 2, 0, 8, 3 plus 3, 9, 3, 2, 1. 165, 166.625 plus 10. That's 11.30. 629,583, 259,166. There we go. There's the ingots for copper sheets done. Three, 1, 4, 7, 9, 1. Eight, 5, 8, 2, 2, 5. Four, 3, 1, 6, 2, 5. Six, 3, 2, 5. 22 plus 4, 5, 3, 5.4, 3, 2, 8, 9, 9. 4, 5, 2, 8, 9, 5. Two, six, four, four, seven, five. Knock that off the list. Bloop. Head over to the plastics facility next. Rubber. going too far. Five, six, two, five. Two, three, four, three, seven, five. Mean 2 5 and 2 3 4. UPM oil. Updated the notepad at the same time. Yeah. 986111. Six, one, UPM, 3 UPM, warehouse, 185.979166, oil, 3 UPM, right. Honey bears. I think it's time for me to take a break. Feeling a bit tired because I'm going up early for the meeting. yeah, that's going to be it for now. Thanks for joining. Goodbye.